Hello everyone, Chopper Gaming here. Welcome back to another Ash Echoes video. Today we're diving into the very first version update the game going to have. It's including two new heroes gonna be released, as well as many events. And not only that, but I assume they're going to be an exclusive shop for this event. So let's just dive into this event in deep to check out all the event information and everything related to it that they have released for us today. The event called Tomorrow is a Blooming Day. That's the main event. It will be starting from the 28th of November till the 26th of December. And the possibility to be able to unlock this, you need to be completing the main story S1 stage 12, Where the Heart Goes. And the event end for Tomorrow's a Blooming Day event stages will open for a limited time. Players can obtain event reward pay by clearing stages and completing the event quests or redeem them from the event shop. And there will be three stages or three paths for this event. The first one going to be the commercial district, and this one gonna be lasting from the 28th of November till the 26th, as well as the second path gonna be New Town. It will be starting from November 30 till December 26th. And the third one, the Old Town, going to be starting from the 3rd of December till the end of, or till the 26th of December. So we're basically going to have three events into the main event, and each one of them going to be having its own starting date. So for the next thing, the Barret quests, as you can see over here, it's including the Vestal Knight, which is a memory trace and SSR. I think we're able to get it from the shop over here. And consume Frostfear coin to redeem event rewards from the shop. And the Barret quest, during the event, players can complete Barret quest by clearing event stages to gain rewards. And the reward is including dice, Frostfear, coins, badge of projections, and even more. And now for the shop of the event, the Lucky Shop. It's going to be starting of the 28th of November till the 26th of December. During this period, make sure to be collecting as much as possible from the coins to be using it in the shop as well, because it's, I assume, going to be including exclusive event items. For the details, during the event, players can obtain Frost Coin by clearing event stages and completing the Barret quests. The Frost Fair coins can be used to redeem items from the Lucky Shop. For the rewards, it's including an SSR Memory Trace Festival Knight and the Transcript Festival Knight as well, Resonation Clue, Momentary Backfish Event Commemorative, as well as furnitures and even more. And the Ecomancer's Carlight can have special interaction with the furnitures. Carlight's Wind Chime, the Ecomancer's Bali Tusu can have special interaction with the furnitures. Bali Tusu's Mask too. Seems interesting. Yeah, I've always been interesting to find out what's the use of the furnitures, which apparently with this text, it's connected to some heroes or ecomancers going to be having a use to the furnitures. For the next thing, the second point in the event, going to be a limited time targeted resonation open, Scarlet Skies Aged Brew, which seems to be a limited time target, and it's going to be from the 28th of November till the 12th of December. I assume we're going to have a rate up to summon her, along with these three over here. I guess this is the four heroes that can be making a separate team. For the event duration, it's starting from the November 28th till December the 12th. And the details during the event, the follow characters enjoy a rating up. Gonna be SSR Scarlet, SR Azusa, Ixing, Ling, as well as Felicios. I don't know the names. This is a targeted resonation pool and shares the same petty system with summoning event of the same type. Please tap the details button in the bottom right corner of the summoning page for more information. Okay, so we're going to have two exclusive summoning rate for each one of them. Scarlet gonna have one, and after, straight after the banner of her done, we're gonna have Bailey too, so to be coming up with the rate up, as well as a three over here to be having the rate up as well for them. Going to be Roar, Raid, and Bilia. Yep, Raid is one really I find interesting, especially because he's applying the Fire Zone. Really interesting hero. I have been using him and pretty much good. The event duration or the limited time for this one going to be from the 12th of December till the 26th of December. And during this event, you will be having the rate up to these four heroes, including the SSR, Bailey, as well as the 3SR. This is a targeted resonation pool. Okay, so really gonna be interesting. I'm more curious about to find out their skills. I'm not really sure if I have seen these heroes into the game. Well, I can easily just go to the game and check out in the summon. We've gone to the normal one over here. Okay, so it seemed like there will be a complete two brand new heroes coming up. This is really interesting now. I'm more excited to see exactly how their skills gonna be like. Well, yeah, remember that there is a trial to them on the official YouTube channel to the game. I'll leave to you in the description the link to this trial so you can check it out as well. For the next one, gonna be a limited time targeted trace open going off, of course, which is the memory trace, I assume. Yep, going to be a memory trace summon. Starting of November 28 till December 26, and during this event or this period, we're gonna have a rate up to three of the memory traces, the SSR going off, of course, as well as the SR reunion, which is the terminal, as well as the lawful cage. We're gonna focus on a defense, and going off course is focusing on attack too. So we're going to have really multiple of the rate up summoning sessions. Gonna be really interesting now. For the next one, going to be special stories code Pandora. During this event, it's starting of the 28th till 28th November till the 26th of December. And during the event information here, as the festivals go on, Scarlet reflect on the experience of her past, while Violet Tusa's actual past nightmare emerges quietly. During the event, complete the corresponding quests to unlock the special quests, the special stories code Pandora. Okay, so we're going to have even more of mini games in here too, which is going to be, I assume, gonna have its own rewards. The next one in this patch or the version update gonna be event gameplay Float Barret. During the event, gonna be from November 28 till the 26th of December. The new gameplay Float Barret is coming soon. Drive the float to overcome obstacles along the way and enjoy endless surprises obtained event rewards by completing the event missions. And the rewards gonna be the Frost Fair coins, X particles, and more. Okay. For the next one, the next point gonna be boss challenge Clash of Floats. And it's starting of November 30 till December 26. And this one, to be able to have access to the boss challenge, we need to be completing the Barret commercial distract. So we need to be actually working on the previous quest over here, this one, to be able to actually have access to the boss with its own exclusive rewards. For the event info, boss challenge mode will be available during the time. Directors can select the difficulty level of the boss and get scores based on the challenge result. Reach a specified score to complete quests and win rewards. So pretty much it's the same like the museum event that's running right now. And for the rewards, it's gonna be OE coins, Frost Fair coins, and more. For the next point, the story episode number 4, The Underground. And this one gonna be opening from the... Okay, so this is a new story or episode. And it's opening on November 28th to be unlocking this one, the officer, we need to be having the level to level 26 and complete story episode S315, Path of Thrones. And for the story preview, the aircraft you are on ends up crashing on the border between Illinois and Sumash, and your companions are scattered all over the place, unable to contact each other while searching to your own companions. You encounter an unexpected figure and uncover a horrifying experience. So we're actually going to have even more of a story campaign or some more quests, and yeah, actually I saw this one. It's connected to, like, going here to the world, it's connected to here. Yeah, in the story, this one over here going to be opening in some date. Yeah, it should be in here. Yeah, it should be one of these ones here. Okay, moving back to the version update. So we're having the story episode, gonna be having the underground. Okay, for the next one, New Nexus Path, Mirage, War-Torn Region. So we're gonna have a new Nexus. Okay. It's always good to be working on this one, so we can be having more of the lower captains or leaders. The opening going to be from the 5th of December, and to be able to have access to this one, you need to complete story episode S414, Self-Constructions. And the Nexus Path Info gonna be grant access to the exclusive Pulse skill, Sandbreaker Domain. This skill can counter the sand's protection effect and deal extra damage to targets with sand's protection, ineffective after sand's protection is destroyed. Okay, I haven't really noticed this one. Well, looking to that, I haven't really reached that far. For the rewards, gonna be a momentary backflash and more items. For the next point, going to be a Nexus special event, the Festival Morning. It's starting from the 12th of December till the 26th of December. To be able to have access to it, you're going to need to be completing Nexus surface. Entering the event, completing echoing Nexus each time rewards a certain number of power drum beats. Upon reaching a specific milestones, you can claim generous rewards on the corresponding event page at the event center. And for the reward, it's including an SR, Memory Traces, the Festival Morning, Transcript, Festival's Morning, and the Black Flight, X-Particles, and some extra items too. For the next point, going to be the limited time sign-up event, the Auspicious Day. The duration from the 14th of December till the 28th of December. And during the event, sign up for 7 days in total to get a gilded Binto, 20 of it, and other cultivation rewards. Now I'm curious to find out this part. For the rewards, gonna be, which we have already mentioned now. For the next one, gonna be simultaneously raid Siphonies. The duration of this event gonna be from the 16th of December till the 26th of December. To be able to reach this one, you need to complete the main story as 211 the seed. And for the event information, during the event you can receive a certain number of com whistle every day. It has 6 different difficulties level. After selecting the difficulty, you can consume a common whistle to start simultaneously raid accumulating points, increasing the highest score, and clearing a difficulty for the first time can earn various rewards, which I assume gonna be the first time clearance rewards. And it's for the reward, it's including particle X particles, wide drive, memory packed SSR, the gilded onigiri, as well as the black light and more items. And then moving to the next point, the Meow Setters limited time pack available. Going to be some offers to be having, you know, limited time offers. It's always something gonna be available in any kind of exclusive events. And this duration for these packs is going to be from the 28th of November till the 26th of December. And this one here going to be starting with $10 and it end up by $100. For this one, honestly, I'm not really a spender in this kind of games, partly. So I'm not really going to cover this part, but There are going to be some exclusive rewards and packs to be buying if you would like to. And you can just pause the video so you can check them out if you would like to, so you know exactly what's going to be coming in these packs, to be aware of it and plan how you're going to be getting them, or if you're having a plan to be getting these exclusive packages. That's all, guys, for the very first version update Ash Echo is going to have. Make sure to be sharing with me in the comments your thoughts about this version update and your expectation on these two new heroes. If they will be really that strong, decent, or gonna be poor, just put them aside. I'll be more than happy to hear your opinions about them. And yeah, I'm about to be watching that trial myself to be checking out their gameplay, their skills, and everything related to them. For now, take care all, and make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel to not be missing my videos in the future. Till then, take care and enjoy your game.